Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over a few examples of the SUMIF function.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
Here I have a spreadsheet in Microsoft Excel. First, I have the region where my products are located. Then I have my product ID, and then the sales amount of my product. And what I would like to do for my two different SUMIF examples is first, I would like to sum up the sales amount column if the value is greater than $15,000. And then I would like to sum up the sales amount based on a certain product ID. So how do I go about doing this? Well, for our first scenario, where the sales amount is greater than $15,000, let's go into F3 and just type equals sum if with a left parenthesis. Now, the first argument I'm going to be prompted for is the range. And this is the range where I have a certain kind of criteria that is going to be evaluated. So in this case, I'm going to do column C. And I'm just going to highlight the entire column. And then I'm going to type a comma. And then I will be prompted for criteria. And remember, the criteria that we want here is anything greater than 15,000. But the criteria needs to go in double quotes. So I'm going to type a double quote, a greater than sign, and then 15,000. And my double quotes, and end my parenthesis. And then I'm going to hit enter. And I can see that a sum has been calculated here. If I have that column C and I look down here on my status bar, I can see that the sum of this entire column is 2.6 million. But right here, the salaries that have been calculated are less than that. So I know that this is only summing those values that are greater than 15,000. So if I highlight column C, and I go to home and I go to my conditional formatting and I highlight cell rules. Let's highlight anything less than 15,000 and say, okay. So I have my 12,000 here. I'm going to hold down control, my 12,000 here and my 11,000 here. So if I select all of those and look down here, I can see that's about 168,000. And that is about the amount that I'm off. So again, if I highlight column C, it's 2.6 million. Yet I'm getting 2.4 million. So that is about 168,000 off. So that looks right.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Now, what if I wanted to sum my amount based on criteria from a different column? So in this case, let's say I want to sum everything where my product ID is 1001 or whatever I have in B3 right here. So let's do that in cell F4. So this time I'm going to type equals sum if with a left parenthesis. And I'm going to be asked for a range. And remember that this range is the range for which you're evaluating the criteria. It is not necessarily the range that you are summing. And we'll get to that in a minute. In our previous example, it was, but we are going to use this optional sum range over here to make the range that we are summing different than the criteria range. So for the criteria range, let's highlight column B. And then I'm going to type a comma. And my criteria here, I can either in double quotes put 1001, like that, or I can backspace and just click on a cell that has the value that I would like to evaluate. And then I can type a comma. And then my optional argument here is what is the sum range? So by default, the sum range will be whatever I picked for the first argument for range, like we did in our previous example. But for here, I'm going to highlight column C. And then I'm going to close my parentheses and hit enter. And I can see that I got 413,870. And because this is sorted by product ID, Let's just see what happens if I highlight all the 1,000 ones. If I look down here on my status bar, I can see that I am getting 413,870. So that number does match this. And this has summed up everything in the sales column where the product ID column is equal to 1,001. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction to a couple different ways to use the SUMIF function. There is also a function called SUMIFS, S-U-M-I-F-S, that you can use if you have multiple criteria that you would like to evaluate. And we explain that in another video that we'll put on our end screen. So if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.